Meiosis is the term used to describe replication of cells, where the cells produced have half the number of chromosomes as the original cells. This means that if the cells originally had two sets of chromosomes, then the daughter cells will have only one set of chromosomes. The new cells produced will be called gametes, or reproductive cells, such as egg cells or sperm cells or pollen. These gametes will then fuse and create a new individual. Meiosis is similar to mitosis, but also differs in a few ways. First, the resulting cells will not be doing growth, but rather will be readying for sexual reproduction. And when the process is completed, there will be only one chromosome of each homologous pair present in the daughter cells. Since the resultant cells are different, this is not called a cell cycle. The beginning of meiosis is the same as in mitosis, with interphase occurring in the same manner. The time for meiosis can vary considerably and is affected by many different factors. Meiosis is divided into four phases which are repeated. Each phase has distinctive features occurring in them. Prophase 1, nucleic acids condense into chromosomes, followed by a network of microtubules beginning to extend from the centrioles to the chromosomes, attaching at the centromeres of the replicated chromosomes. In order for the microtubules to be able to do this, the nuclear membrane dissipates. This phase is the longest of all of the phases and can take a considerable period of time. Metaphase 1. Since the chromosomes are pulled on both sides, they arrive at the center of the cell. Meta stands for middle. So in this phase, the chromosomes align in the center of the cell. Anaphase 1. This is a change from mitosis, as rather than individual chromosomes separating, the homologous pairs of chromosomes separate. So each resulting cell will have one double of each chromosome. Telophase 1 is basically the reverse of prophase, with the nuclear membrane reestablishing. The cells now divide and are followed by a new set of phases, just like what occurred. Prophase 2, a network of microtubules begins to extend from the centrioles to the chromosomes, attaching at the centromeres of the chromosomes. The nuclear membrane dissipates. Metaphase 2, the chromosomes are pulled on both sides. They arrive in a line in the center of the cell. Anaphase 2. Each chromosome is separated, so each resulting cell will have one half of the number of chromosomes present in the original cell. They are haploid. Telophase 2 is basically the reverse of prophase, with the nuclear membrane reestablishing. At this point, the cell wall is established between the cells. The process of meiosis is very important as it allows for continued passage of genetic material into gametes that can then form a zygote. This sexual reproduction allows for mixing of genetic materials so that there is variability of the offspring. Meiosis allows for future generations to have genetic variability, which allows for genetic health and survivability.